Dear CG Thinker, welcome. When the add-on was released, a question has often been asked. Is it possible to add details on an already existing texturing? The answer is yes. As I said in the teaser, as well as on the sales page, Materializer allows you to create textures, yes, but also to add details and nuances on an already existing classic texturing. There are several ways to do this depending on your goal, but today I'm going to show you an extremely simple way to add interesting details to your textures. As this is my first video since the release of the add-on, I would like to take this opportunity to say a big thank you. A big thank you to the whole Blender community for the welcome you have given to this new project. I already have a lot of ideas for the future versions, and you also have a lot of ideas that you have already shared with me on the Discord. Once again, thank you for your support. Let's start the tutorial. Here is the starting situation. A share from the Chocofur website on which I applied a texture that was found from the Ambient CG website. First step, break the homogeneity of the texture. Here, the idea is to add a global overlay to the whole object to make the texture much more random. Press Shift A to find the Hue Saturation node. Go to the side panel and the Fluent tab to import a grunge node, grunge 00, which I set up like this. The setting is okay, and I simply connect the output result of the node to the FAC input of the Hue Saturation node. Now I just have to play with this node to add some variation in the wood texture. Second step, damage edges. A texture is all the more successful if it takes into account the geometry of the object. We continue on the same principle by using again a Hue Saturation node. We duplicate the node with the shortcut Shift D. We simply place it after and we reset the value except for the last parameter, which I changed to 2. Let's now call the node that will allow us to see this effect only on the edges. Press F, then select all edges. I set the distance and connect the output mask to the input FAC. As you have understood, I think, homogeneity, regularity is your worst enemy. So let's make these edges more random by adding a grunge node, the grunge 03. This is starting to look pretty good. Third step, darker cavity area. Still with the same idea, with a new Hue Saturation node, a cavity mask, and another grunge 3 node, we are going to make the cavity areas of the model darker and dirtier. That's how to make any texture more convincing. That's how to change the story that this model will tell. To take it a step further, we can go back to using layers to add new elements to the texture to tell a much darker story. Step 4. Let your imagination run wild. I select the principal BSDF, press the F key and request a smart shader with two layers. I select the principal BSDF, press F key and request a smart shader with two layers. The first layer is of course on my base texture, so I connect the color, roughness and normal input with what was originally directly connected to the principal BSDF. For the second layer, let's say it will be blue. So we change the color to red, as for the mask that will separate two layers, I'm going with the not grunge gradient one. Let's to be clear, there is one that has a bad time here. We could go further in the delirium by adding drops of blood or blood flowing. That's not the point here, but why not? Feel free to unleash your cruelty on this model. Here is how, with simple hue saturation nodes combined with Fluent Materializer nodes, we can add interesting detail to make it more believable. I hope this tutorial will have interested you, learned something. Don't hesitate to subscribe to don't miss the rest, either here or on the Discord. See you soon. Bye.